Next up is the very, very lovely and dancerly Jenny Eckton from Formerly Fred, at Formerly Fred at formerlyfred.com. Welcome her up.
Evolution of a Dream is the title of my presentation tonight. We all have dreams, things that we wanted to be when we were little, and things that, let's be honest, have been pushed to the back burner in our lives because we can't do everything. I mean, am I right? But the reality is that pursuing your dream doesn't mean giving up the life that you've got. In order to pursue your dream, you don't need to give up your career. You don't need to change careers necessarily. All you need to do is define your dream and then redefine it, sometimes continuously. When I was little, I wanted to be a lot of things. I wanted to be Wonder Woman, clearly. I wanted to be on Broadway. I wanted to be a rock star. I wanted to be a mom and a lawyer and a music teacher and a million other things. Not all of those things have fit into my life. But in order to focus, I maybe should have paid attention to the Billboard number one song the week I was born, because it was Dancing Queen by ABBA. I love to dance, but when I was little, we couldn't afford dance lessons. Somehow, though, at age 14, I made my way to my friend's grandma's dance studio and was able to take some lessons. I know, please, it's too old to start. And I didn't care that how awkward it was, because I loved performing. I loved dancing in front of people. And my favorite way to dance was to learn dances from videos on MTV. This is my life right now. This is what my life looks like when we're dressed up and well-behaved. The reality of my life is that I drive around in my minivan a lot, and I can make Kraft dinner with my eyes closed. And please don't misunderstand me. That part of my life is intentional. And when I see my kids dance on stage, though, that spark comes back, and I'm like, I want to dance. I want to dance for people, and I don't know how it's going to happen, but it's going to happen. Sorry, I'm a crybaby. The first time I saw this skit on Saturday Night Live with these guys, I laughed so hard, and I knew that was the dance I was going to learn. So I watched the Single Ladies video, which is beautiful and so artistically directed, but it's fast, and there are a lot of different camera angles, and there is strobe lighting, and it is hard to learn. So I did the best I could, but then I did a little research, and I found a group of comedians called the Dan Band, and they also do a version of the Single Ladies dance, which is done in one take. It is amazing, and they are simplified moves, and they are kid-friendly. And so guess what? In my family room, with YouTube in front of us, with my kids, these, when we weren't, you know, painting our faces and cleaning up all those eggs, we learned the Single Ladies dance. So now I knew this dance, and what was I going to do with it? Where was I going to perform? Fast forward to 2010, when I began attending blogging conferences. At Blog Her in New York City, on stage, dancing with friends that I met at Evo 10. We're up there and we're dancing on the stage. You guys remember this, yeah? And we're having a great time. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this is it. I'm going to do the dance tonight. And I might only dance for one friend, but I'm going to do it. There was one thing standing in my way, and that was I couldn't control which song was played. So you know what I did? This is critical. I went up to the DJ, and I did not leave his side until he agreed to play Single Ladies. He gave me every excuse. I already played Beyoncé. The party's almost over. I didn't care. I said, will you play Single Ladies? And he said, yes. And I hopped off the stage, and I got on the floor, and it turned out to be the very last song that night. But you know what I did? I did that dance, you guys. And before I knew it, a circle had formed around me, and it was like I was in my own John Hughes movie. And people were cheering for me. And afterwards, people were like, are you professionally trained? And I said, no, I learned this in my family room. And then I went to another party, and I did it again. And so much good has come from this, from me living out this dream, not the least of which was the best tweet of my life, which I still read over and over again. Take a minute. That tweet makes me smile to this day. I'm not kidding. When I am having a bad day, I pull that up and I read it because it makes my day. So what about you? What is your dream? I want you to define it and then redefine it until it fits in your life. Identify the people who can help you. Who's your DJ? Who's going to play your song? And then you have the courage to be proactive and make it happen. Look, I am well beyond becoming a professional dancer, But my body cages a soul that craves dance. And so I can do it with my kids by my side. And that's what I do. So whether your dream, whether your dream is to become a baker or a fashion designer, I don't care how ludicrous it seems, you can do it. I'm Jenny Eckton. My blog is formerlyfred.com. You can find me anywhere, Formerly Fred. Thank you so much.
The sun goes down, the stars come out, and all that counts is here and now. My universe will never be the same. I'm glad you came. Cast a spell on me, you hit me like the sky fell on me, and I decided you look well on me, so let's go somewhere no one else can see you and me. Turn the lights out now, now I'll take you by the hand, hand you another drink, drink it if you can you spend a little time, time is slipping away, away from us, so stay. Make you glad you came. The sun goes down, the stars come out, and all that counts is here and now. My universe will never be the same. I'm glad you came. I'm glad you came. You came. The sun goes down, the stars come out, and all that counts is here and now. My universe will never be the same. I'm glad you came. I'm glad you came. And all that counts is here and now. My universe will never be the same. I'm glad you came. I'm glad you came.